गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 10 वेव ऑप्टिक्स एंड दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 11। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस लॉ ऑफ मैलस, ब्रूस्टर्स लॉ एंड पोलरॉइड इन दिस लेक्चर। इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न अबाउट द पोलराइजेशन ऑफ लाइट, राइट। तो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देयर इज ए मैलस लॉ और लॉ ऑफ मैलस, राइट। तो इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन दैट वी हैव टू क्रिस्टल्स, वन इज पोलराइजर एंड अनदर वन इज पोलराइजर एंड एनालाइजर। द फर्स्ट क्रिस्टल कन्वर्ट द ऑर्डिनरी लाइट इनटू पोलराइज्ड लाइट एंड द सेकंड क्रिस्टल परफॉर्म आइडेंटिफाई दैट लाइट इज ऑर्डिनरी और पोलराइज्ड, राइट। तो द वर्क ऑफ द सेकंड क्रिस्टल इज टू एनालाइज द पोलराइज्ड लाइट, राइट। नाउ देयर इज ए एंगल बिटवीन पोलराइजर एंड एनालाइजर। इफ दिस एंगल इज 0 और 180, तो पोलराइज्ड लाइट विल पास्ड थ्रू द एनालाइजर। इफ देयर इज ए एंगल बिटवीन क्रिस्टल एक्सिस ऑफ पोलराइजर एंड एनालाइजर इज 90 degree, देन नो लाइट विल बी कम आउट फ्रॉम द एनालाइजर। नाउ सी, दीज आर टू क्रिस्टल्स, पोलराइजर एंड एनालाइजर, एंड द एंगल बिटवीन देयर एक्सिस इज थीटा। सो द इंटेंसिटी ऑफ लाइट विच इज कमिंग आउट फ्रॉम द एनालाइजर विल डिपेंड ऑन द एंगल बिटवीन polarizer and crystal axis of polarizer and analyzer. When the beam of plane polarized light is incident on the analyzer, the intensity I of light transmitted from the analyzer varies directly as square of cosine of angle theta between planes of transmission of analyzer and polarizer. It means the intensity of emergent light from the analyzer will directly proportional to cos square theta, right. Now this is I is directly proportional to cos square theta. See, this is the amplitude, and if we split this into horizontal and vertical component, the horizontal component A cos theta will pass through this analyzer, and intensity depends on square of amplitude. It means A cos square theta is directly proportional to intensity. So the law of Malus becomes I is directly proportional to cos square theta, right. If the A is amplitude of electric vector or light vector transmitted by polarizer, then the only A cos theta component will transmit by the analyzer, right. That's why I is directly proportional to cos square theta, right. The intensity of transmitted light from analyzer is I is equal to K A cos theta whole square, and we can write it as I is equal to K A square cos square theta. So it can be written as I is equal to I naught cos square theta. It means when the light of I naught intensity falls on the analyzer, right, so the intensity of emergent light will be I. Now, if theta is 0, cos theta is 1, it means I is equal to I naught. If theta is 180, it means cos theta is minus 1, but the square of minus 1 is again plus 1, so I is equal to I naught, right. Means when two crystals, polarizer and analyzer, are parallel to each other and their axes are also parallel to each other, the intensity of emergent light will be maximum. If theta is 90 degree, तो cos theta becomes zero. It means intensity of emergent light will be zero, right? When unpolarized light is incident on analyzer, the intensity of transmitted light will be one half of intensity of the incident light, right? It means we should go to the previous slide to understand it. If the intensity of light, unpolarized light, is 2i or 2i naught, so the intensity of polarized light will be I naught. Reason is that half of the component will be stopped by this polarizer, so the intensity will becomes half. Now if these two are parallel to each other, then the intensity of emergent light will be I naught again, right? But if polarizer, if analyzer at 90 degree, for example, in the previous slide, in this case, if intensity of incident light is I 2I naught, the light intensity at this portion will be I naught, and here the intensity will be I naught, right? But in the second case, if there is intensity 2I naught, the intensity will be here will be I naught, and the intensity of emergent light will be zero, since half of the component is stopped by this crystal and the remaining vibrations are stopped by this crystal, that is analyzer, so the intensity of emergent light will becomes zero, right? Now we are going to next slide. In board examination you will get one question at least from the law of malice, and that is in the form of numericals, right? Now polarization by reflection and Brewster's law. Polarization by reflection. Now see, these are two media A and B. The unpolarized light means the light in which the electric vectors are vibrating in all possible directions. Incident at this interface at polarizing angle, this is called polarizing angle. So this light divided into two parts, one part reflected and another part will refracted. The refracted light again becomes unpolarized light, but the reflected light becomes completely polarized. Now the vibrations are in only single plane of the reflected ray. It means this is the completely polarized light. Reflected light is completely polarized when angle of incidence is polarizing angle. The incident light wave is made of parallel vibrations, pi components, on the plane of incidence, and the perpendicular vibrations, sigma components, perpendicular to the plane of incidence, right? At a particular angle, polarizing angle theta p, the parallel components completely reflected, whereas perpendicular components partially get refracted and partially get reflected, right? So that's why the reflected light becomes the completely polarized light. Now Brewster states that the reflected component are all in perpendicular plane of vibration, and hence the light is polarized. Now the intensity of transmitted light through the medium is greater than the plane polarized reflected light, right? So we can write it as theta p plus r is equal to 90 degree. Now what is theta p? This theta p is angle of incidence, right? And this r, you know, theta p plus r is equal to 90 degree when the reflected light is completely polarized. So theta p plus r is equal to 90 degree. So we can write it as r is equal to 90 minus theta, right? So एज पर द स्नेल्स लॉ वी शुड राइट ए म्यू बी मीन्स रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ बी विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ए इज इक्वल टू साइन थीटा पी डिवाइडेड बाई साइन आर. Now we can substitute the value of r over here. So we can get a mu b sin theta p divided by sin 90 minus theta p. And sin 90 minus theta p is cos theta. That's why we can write a mu b is equal to 10p. And this is the Brewster's law. So Brewster's law states that the refractive index of the medium with respect to rarer medium depends on the angle of polarization, and that is equal to tangent of angle of polarization. So this is the Brewster's law. Now the last portion of this chapter is Polaroid. Polaroid is an artificial device to produce the polarized light. H polaroid is prepared by taking the sheet of polyvinyl alcohol. This is the important factor. Polyvinyl alcohol, the long chain of polymer molecules, and subjected to the large strain, the molecules are oriented parallel to the strain and the material becomes doubly refracting. When strain with iodine, the material behaves like a dichloric crystal, right? So this is the artificial device. Next, the K polaroids, these are the types of polaroids. K polaroid is prepared by heating a stressed polyvinyl alcohol film in the presence of HCl. When the film becomes slightly darkened, it behaves like a strong dichloric crystal, means the polaroid, right? Now use of the polaroid. How can we use these polaroids? First of all, in sunglasses. Student, you have seen so many type of sunglasses. The sunglasses with polaroid is costly item. Second, polaroid filters. Third, for the laboratory purposes. Fourth, in headlights of automobiles. In expensive automobiles, there is a polaroid for the headlights, right? So the light gets filtered and becomes the polarized light. Next, three-dimensional motion picture means 3D pictures, 3D movies, right? Window panes of aeroplanes. In aeroplanes, there is the window pane of polaroids, made of polaroids. And the last but not the least, in windshield of the automobiles, right? In expensive automobiles. So this is all about the today's lecture and last lecture of the wave optics. Thank you very much.